Hello, everybody. Good evening. Well, it's about that time. I'm gonna take a stab at a bodybuilding supplements and movies motivational sort of ASMR video here. So, the tapping you're hearing is the supplement that I'm gonna start with. Just because if I had to say the one supplement that's really important, it's this glutamine powder. It's a brand called Metrix. Comes in this great bright red bottle. I actually got this from Amazon. This is a, let's see, it's 1 kilo. It's 2.2 pounds. That's the total. Can read that. Essentially, this is an amino acid that supports recovery. The biggest effect that I noticed from it is nowhere near the muscle soreness after workouts that I used to get when I was younger. And also just, you know, you recover much faster. So, you know, we're talking like half the time. I remember the days when I used to do legs. Sometimes I would train, especially my calves, to the point where they'd be so sore that it would be hard to walk for about a week. particularly the second day after training, which is when the soreness seems to peak. And then it would just linger for another 3-4 days. So, since I've been taking glutamine regularly, I never get that sore, no matter how hard I train. So, and this is 20 years later, and obviously I'm well past my physical prime, at least biologically speaking. So, yeah. I take about 2 or 3 servings per day of this, which is about somewhere around 15 to 18 grams. Essentially, it's the scoop is this big. So yeah, it's not a lot that I have to take, and it has a big effect. And I'll open the bottle. A white powder. The taste is somewhat slightly sour, I guess you might say. I don't know. Glutamine has a particular taste. It's not too unpleasant. I often take it with fruit juice, or I mix it into my protein drink, which I take at night. So yeah, there's the glutamine. Very important. Next is creatine, another amino acid. Again, we have a 1 kilo bottle, 2.2 pounds. Essentially, the creatine just gives you a minute but noticeable difference in during training. You notice that your muscles don't tire out quite as quickly. It gives you a little bit of a bump in power. But the thing is, when you're training at the limit of your muscles, it only takes a small, tiny edge to make a big difference in how your training goes. And you're not just talking about the particular day you're training, but it adds up over time so that a little increase every single time you train becomes a very big increase over, let's say, a couple of months. So, with the creatine, I only take about 5 grams a day, which is maybe one spoonful. Again, it is a white powder. Creatine really doesn't have a taste. It just tastes like a white powder, really. Again, I take creatine with fruit juice or in my protein drink, but it really doesn't make much of a difference in its taste. It's kind of gritty is all. So, again, from the Metrics brand. Now we come to BCAA. That's branched chain amino acid. This happens to be from the On brand, which is Optimum Nutrition. The reason I don't use the Metrics brand of BCAA, even though they're pretty similar as far as the breakdown of the three amino acids, I don't like the way the Metrics mixes in any kind of liquid. Like, one of my favorite ways to take BCAA is in the morning or any time before training, in my coffee. And the On brand mixes immediately. So, yeah. It's quite nice. Again, this is the size of the scoop. I take one serving, maybe two servings before training days. So, there you go. And it is a white powder. BCAA definitely doesn't taste too good. It's a little like if there were such a thing as powdered sour cream, but not quite that pleasant. I don't know. I do notice that it just makes things taste creamy if you add this to your protein powder, it'll make it taste a little less sweet, which can be a good thing. And in my coffee, it just, you know, adds to the flavor of the creamy, kind of like I put half and half or something in it. So yeah, this brand is good though. I like it a lot. It's pretty comparable to the Metrics as far as the price and quality. Here's another, yet another amino acid. This is L-Carnitine. This happens to be the variety acetyl L-carnitine, or ALCAR. And it's essentially helps your metabolism, I guess. It basically helps burn fat, supposedly improves your performance, maximizes focus. So it has a bit of a mental effect as well. Now, it says here unflavored, which is pretty hilarious because ALCAR has a very sour taste, extremely sour. It's a little bit like biting into a lemon or a lime, which for me, I don't mind the flavor of that, but it is quite noticeable. So, I've been trying lots of different kinds of L-carnitine, including the tablets, and they don't seem to be a very good value if you buy the tablets. And very often they're a little bit misleading in the way that they label the serving size versus how much the potency actually is. So this, on the other hand, is a very good value. I take about a gram a day, which is two scoops, but the scoops are tiny. You think the other scoop was small? Look at that. That is a 500 milligram scoop, and it's very small. Yeah. So yeah, I basically take this straight in my mouth, basically, and I just enjoy the very sour lemon-lime kind of taste. And yeah, the powder, again, is a white powder. As you might be able to see, there's this moisture absorbing packet because it does cake, has a tendency to cake. But I've had this container a really long time, and I've still barely made a dent in it, and I take this stuff every day, so you can see how long that amount of powder, two or three times a day, will last you. So, but great stuff. I'm not sure how much of an effect I've really noticed from it, but I mean, overall, I'm doing so many different things that it's hard to nail your progress down to any one supplement. But I'm at a point now where I'm willing to try basically anything that doesn't have any side effects, if it'll give me an extra edge. And all I can say is, lately, every single workout I'm getting gains. So, and that's obviously without any kind of illegal supplements or anything I would have to inject or even, you know, yeah. I guess they do make certain performance enhancers that are taken orally, but I avoid anything that's not something natural that you can just buy in the vitamin store, shall we say. Although most of this comes from Amazon. I want to talk about pre-workout. As you can see, this is a GNAR pump, and yes, these are both empty. I'm currently out of pre-workout, so I'm mostly, if I take any pre-workout, it's usually samples that I've gotten from walking into different, you know, health food stores. But this stuff is from BroSupps. If you've possibly run across the Bro Science Life videos on YouTube, this is his line, and obviously all of this is written in a very sarcastic but funny manner. Kimono dragon fruit punch house music, which is actually blue raspberry. And this container was actually a gift for one of my birthdays recently from my brother, kind of as a joke. But the stuff actually really works well. And what I really like is they do tell you every single thing that's in there, down to exactly how many milligrams, which is very nice, because a lot of pre-workouts just tell you some proprietary blend, and then they won't tell you that they really didn't put a lot of anything in there. But I tried the blue raspberry, and I gotta tell you, if I even just open this container, I wish you could smell that. This blue raspberry, I mean, it's wonderful, the flavor. It's what you would expect blue raspberry to taste like, but because some of the substances in here that kind of are pump agents or whatever, they're very bitter. So it definitely affects the taste and makes it a little more complex to me. It's not just kind of a one-dimensional sweet blue raspberry flavor. I guess the only way to explain it is it reminds me of the smell of the ocean, if that's an aroma that you happen to like, which I do. So, yeah, this is a really good flavor. And I only need one serving of this to be very amped up in the gym. It definitely helps you stay focused and stay energetic all the way through. So, good stuff. Like it a lot. This isn't going to be too loud, but a big bag of Synthesix protein powder. The thing about this stuff is I've even gotten the spiel from people trying to sell me somebody else's protein powder that that the 22 grams per serving versus how many grams a serving actually is supposedly means that it's filled with filler. But if you really break it down, it's stuff that you want, believe me. For one thing, there's fiber, 5 grams of fiber per serving. And if you're doing low carb, you know fiber becomes a bit of something that you do have to make sure you get enough of. And 22 grams of protein is a nice amount. You get the essential aminos, 10 grams, and then there's a certain amount of fat. And although it is artificially flavored, it also has just enough small amount of sugar, more than usual, because, you know, a lot of these powders are low carb and are artificially sweetened. But the thing I love about this is that I've gone through, I don't know, 60 pounds of it maybe by now, 60 or 70 pounds, and I'm still not tired of the flavor. And most every other kind I've tried tastes hideous after about 3 or 4 times of drinking it. So, yeah. I'm down to only taking maybe 1 to 1.5 servings of this per day, usually at night before I go to bed. So I don't rely that heavily on protein powder anymore. At most, I would take maybe, you know, 4 servings a day. That's when I was really trying to be on a bulking phase. But, yeah, I've backed that off a lot. Let's talk about the tablets and stuff that comes in smaller bottles. So, here we have the DHEA. Now, this is mainly because I am over 40 and definitely have noticed that, you know, every once in a while I'll have moods that I'm probably thinking are as a result of the testosterone leveling off a little bit. So I've definitely looked into a lot of natural things, like, you know, avoiding personal care products that have parabens and various kinds of, you know, stuff that basically poisons your body and acts like estrogen. So couple of things, just minor toothpaste, hair products. I'll eventually make some sort of a products video that shows some of the new stuff I've been doing, and it sort of helps, but I take 2 of these per day, so 50 milligrams, a very safe amount, and it's just a really general kind of hormone booster. Mostly what I notice is just, though, that my moods are very stable. You know, no kind of random malaise. And it just, you know, it made my training a lot better. As soon as I was suffering the effects of not, you know, this was maybe 3 years ago when I realized I really needed to get serious about training again. But, you know, being over 40, I was starting to feel all those random pains that, you know, your parents always complain about, and you wonder, you know, what happened to you? Your back, you know, shoulders, knees, whatever, just random pains that, you know, made me feel like I was getting old, you know? And obviously training really suffered. I'd go for 20, maybe 30 minutes and my body would beg me to go home. So, yeah, that was a 2-month hell to get over. Just gotta keep going back, you know? But this stuff really helped, and so I still do take it. You know, like I said, they've done tests, you know, up to 200-300 milligrams per day, and the side effects are pretty minor. So the small amount I'm taking really, you know, it helps a little bit, but it doesn't really have any side effects. course, I do take a multivitamin. And this is the GNC brand, Mega Men. I only take one of these every day. The serving size is two, but I try to get fairly healthy food as much as possible, and so I just take one of these per day just to make sure that all the nutrients are at the levels they should be. So, also because any vitamins that contain a lot of zinc usually upset my stomach. So, and this does have a certain amount of zinc in it down here. So I really have to be careful about the multivitamins. I just feel like, you know, they help a little bit, but I don't feel the necessity to, you know, to go overboard with them. I even take days off of taking these every now and then. Okay, now we have the Kirkland brand of glucosamine. This is for joint and cartilage support. Essentially, I had a nagging left shoulder that really prevented training from really being at the level it should be. And it's been something that has nagged me off and on since I was in my 20s, so it's nothing new. And I've looked at other places where I could improve, like my flexibility, my form in the gym, and so forth. But obviously, supplements can sometimes help with joint problems. And I tried a bunch of different brands of glucosamine, and most of them felt like a placebo. They really didn't seem like they were doing anything. And so went to Costco and bought these one time. These are amazingly good value. This bottle, it's, you know, you take two of these per day and it'll take you a really long time to go through the bottle, and it's probably about $9. So yeah, so I'm pretty happy to have these. And the last supplement that I take is fish oil. The main reason that this was recommended, omega-3s are supposed to be good for your heart, purified to remove mercury. But I've had LASIK done on my eyes about 10 years ago now. And one of the side effects of LASIK is that if you have dry eyes, LASIK tends to increase that. So one of my eye doctors recommended that I add a fish oil supplement because it helps with the dry eye. And I've definitely noticed that when I don't take these, I seem to just feel my eyes getting uncomfortable more often, even though I try to drink more water and so forth. I have to reach for my artificial tears more often rather than just at night. So if I do take the fish oil at night, if I happen to wake up, and when I first get up in the morning, that's the only times I need the eye drops. The rest of the day I'm fine. So yeah, if it also has the benefit to your heart, then wonderful. I mean, I also eat Smart Balance peanut butter, which is high in omegas as well. But yeah, this supplement is nice, and I take two of these soft gels per day. These are rather large, so this is definitely the horse pill group. I don't know how big that looks to you, but this is, taking two of these with everything else, that's huge. All right. Okay. Well, now, the other thing I wanted to show you guys is my modest collection of bodybuilding inspiration videos. So let's start with, if I can get the glare out of here. Let's just put it down, shall we? The Kevin Levrone Maryland Muscle Machine video. Obviously you've seen this before in one of my, you know, collection, DVD and Blu-ray collection videos. You can see this massive amount of weight that he uses for the leg press machine, although the leg sled machine really doesn't have much range of motion, so that's a lot of weight, but the weight probably moves up and down about 8 or 9 inches, I don't know. It's not much, but I mean, he's strong. He's really strong, and you'll see that in other places in this video. I mean, he's doing shoulder press in the Smith machine behind his head with four plates on each side. Yeah, shrugs with something like 6 plates on. Yeah, benching 500 pounds plus for reps. But yeah, he also, there's a lot in this video of his meals. So he eats a lot of fish, a lot of fish. And a lot of brown rice and veggies. So the food preparation scenes are really fun to watch as well, because it definitely motivates me to eat a little cleaner along with the training. So, and I mentioned in the previous video, I actually knew Kevin for a brief period when I worked at a Macintosh repair shop that was 2 doors from his World Gym in Maryland. So, yeah, saw him around the gym a lot, just being the boss since he owned the place. But occasionally ran into him while he was in there training too. But yeah, talked to him pretty frequently. So, my other bodybuilder that I really like is Jay Cutler, and this here, I believe, is his first DVD. I'm not sure. I like this mostly because of the period. I have to admit, I'm a little nostalgic when it comes to these old gym videos. Just the atmosphere in the gym, even the clothes. I mean, I guess, you know, I kind of miss the time when it wasn't as cynical, let's say. You could wear these, you know, clothes that are designed for bodybuilders so that you can see, you know, you can see your muscles developing. These days, if you wore something like this to the gym, you'd probably feel pretty uncomfortable, just because of the way other people, you know, give you kind of side eye or whatever. But yeah, like, this was before he got to the point where, I mean, he was pro, but he wasn't quite a champion just yet. So his physique was a little different proportions, and in some ways he's almost more aesthetics this way. He's not quite as freaky size and, you know, a little flatter through the abs, but he's still got ridiculous definition, so... this video isn't quite as long, so that's the only thing that I kind of wish it were a little longer and more detailed, but it shows a fair amount of training and some of his meals and some posing, stuff like that. Then we get to what I believe is his second DVD, which is the new Improved and Beyond. By now he's living out in Vegas, training out in Vegas. You get to see his full house, which is pretty cool. He takes you on an entire house tour. And his place in Vegas was really nice. So, shows his garage and his tiny little treadmill that he has there. Shows him getting a massage. There's some meal times. And of course, you know, lots of training. This is a double disc. So, yeah. So, yeah, there's a ton of footage on here. So, pretty much his entire workout cycle is shown on here in full detail. So, and I mean, he's pressing some serious weight in this. When he's doing chest, for instance, when he's doing incline, he's got four plates on. So, that's pretty motivating. but yeah, there's a lot of interesting things to this. The one thing I don't like about this DVD is his training partner is a little loud sometimes. And it's kind of more fun when he's just training with his wife, his ex-wife now, I guess. But when he's just training with his wife or by himself, it just seems more fun to watch than when he's with his bro, friend, whoever that was training with him and being kind of loud, so. Well, I need a drink of water here. All right. if I had to point to my go-to training motivation and mealtime motivation video, it would be this one, Jay Cutler, Ripped to Shreds. At this point, he's already a Mr. Olympia. Two-time, I think, maybe. Yeah. Third consecutive Arnold Classic win as well. But yeah, this is more pre-contest, so he's very ripped. I mean, really dialed in as far as his physique and shredded, you know, all his fat levels really low. Otherwise, it follows a lot of the same format as the one I just showed you. It's two discs. You got, you know, 3.5 hours of footage. And yeah, again, shows his house quite a lot. In Las Vegas, and he trains at several different Vegas Gold's gyms. So, yeah, it's a pretty cool one to have. I like this one a lot. I tend to watch disc one the most. That's the one that has his leg day and his meal times. In fact, I can't even remember what all is on disc two. But yeah, I mean, basically, again, his full cycle, all four of his different training days. So you get to see him train his entire body. So, and in a lot of detail. And like I said, he's mostly training by himself, a little bit with his wife in this video. So yeah, it's just easier to watch either in the background or when you're actually just really watching it, so yeah, enjoy this one a lot. Now we get to the movies that have specifically to do with fitness or bodybuilding. Obviously, Bigger, Stronger, Faster. I'm definitely a subscriber on YouTube to the channel that has come from the guy who did this. It's directed by Chris Bell, but it's his brother Smelly Bell who does the super training videos on YouTube. So, but yeah, this movie is really cool because it goes over all of the different sides of performance enhancers and, you know, the whole idea of cheating, whether or not you consider, you know, steroids dangerous or not. I mean, obviously, you know, politicians love to use it as one of their pet causes, and it just depends on, you know, but it. I just like this because it's a balanced look at everything, you know, so it's a good education in a way, just to give you some other ideas and some different perspectives and the different people that he interviews. Pretty amazing. So. Obviously, pumping iron has to be in here. I like this 25th anniversary edition a lot. I really grew up in an era when this was still, I started lifting weights in the early 80s. So Arnold was very big inspiration back then. And Franco, even. And also some of the other people that appear in this movie. Frank Zane is another big influence. But yeah, like, obviously Schwarzenegger, I don't have to tell you how influential he is. What I also really like, though, is the documentary. There's a little featurette on the making of this movie, and there's even a scene that triggers ASMR. They put on a bodybuilding exposition at the Whitney in New York, the art museum. And so there were just the three of them, and it was treated less as a bodybuilding thing and more like an art show that had to do with the muscular body. I think they named it Articulate Muscle or something like that. But because there's a lot of photography involved and stuff like that, it's, you know, I don't know, just for me, that's one of my triggers. So I find it very relaxing to watch that part of the documentary. So, anyway, yeah. I love the period in Venice, you know, Muscle Beach and all that. Yeah, this captures that really well. All right, I got two more for you. First, so yoga. I have to say, like, I'm not the biggest yoga fan necessarily, but I think it was my senior year in college, I was trying to graduate, and I had, you know, I just had to fill a lot of courses, and some of those were electives, so I took yoga and Tai Chi back to back one day a week, just to help fill out some credits. I have to say, I found yoga very relaxing and also just really good for building strength and balance, flexibility. It just really, it depends a lot on how you approach it. You know, it can kind of be whatever you want it to be. So obviously this particular video is strength building yoga. And Rodney, who's a really good, you know, I don't know, I'm pretty sure he's pretty big in the yoga world. But yeah, this video, just, I like the flow, the different poses that you go through. I'm definitely into spending a little time in each pose and not really just trying to go from one pose to another really quickly in succession. I like to spend, you know, I want 2 minutes plus in downward dog, that kind of thing. I mean, I want to be able to actually, it's almost a meditation and also more challenging physically. So, but you can make it, you know, as hard or as easy as you want to. And I even sent my mom a copy of this. And, you know, she said she was a little intimidated at first, especially because of the the introductory video where he goes through a 5-minute demonstration of some pretty extreme and difficult poses. But she still found that the program worked for her really well. It really, you know, it improved her posture and it improved her strength and basically everything that yoga is supposed to do. So, yeah, this is a great DVD. I think it has two different halves, essentially, but it's basically about an hour plus some interview footage, so it's about an hour and 20 minutes. Some of it says it's filmed in Maui, but it's not really filmed on the beach. There's just this big platform. It's really cool, though. I love the music. Really relaxing, you know, music, and it looks really cool on the screen, so like it very much. And obviously he's very relaxing to listen to as he got you through the different poses. And last, couldn't do a bodybuilding fitness motivation without mentioning Pain and Gain. Really, it's the only Hollywood movie I can think of that explores the bodybuilding world in such a sinister yet loving way. I mean, it's silly and funny and yet legit, you know. Obviously, there are scenes where the scene where Marky Mark is doing close grip bench press with supposedly 315 pounds, and you can clearly see that, you know, 4 out of the 6 plates are fake. So he's probably pressing more like about 150, but the rest of the time, I mean, you know, obviously most of the stuff that Dwayne Johnson does looks pretty real, and, you know, they are obviously in great shape, got pretty big for these roles, so, obviously Dwayne Johnson always is, but Marky Mark's kind of gone on, you know, he's sort of following along with the go crazy extremes, you know, lowest weight, highest weight, lowest weight kind of thing. But yeah, here he's, you know, 200, 220, something like that, and benching 400 plus, you know, at least that's what he says. I'm pretty sure he does, though. But this is a really crazy and funny story as well, so it's one of the better movies I've ever seen from Michael Bay. So yeah, it's sad that the cover barely even shows Anthony Mackie over here. But yeah, the dynamic between the three of them is really awesome. And I mean, everybody else in the supporting cast were amazing too, so I don't know. I think this movie is very underrated. But just gotta remember that it's R-rated, and boy does it earn that rating. So, but yeah. Alright, been talking your guys' ears off, so I think I'm going to leave it right there. Little brush sounds are always fun. Yeah, I hope I gave you some relaxation, and if any of these things help you or motivate you in your training, well, that's great. Obviously, it must be said that I'm not a doctor or a physiologist or any kind of, you know, health professional. I've got a personal training certification that's about 20 years old and out of date, but yeah, I just hope that all of this information helps you in some way, but certainly if you want to take it seriously, you want to see a professional first and make sure you're healthy and on, and all the usual disclaimers, just to make sure that you know, approach it intelligently. But yeah, like I said, hope you enjoyed this. It was fun to do, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.